from Pittsburgh is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. Nice kick, plenty of distance, and it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The Volunteers and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
Hard to get to guys and make tackles in space.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. And that brings up fourth down.
Great stop by the defense. They played with tremendous character on those downs.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. The ball changes hands on the punt. Nice opening stand by the defense.
Well, they had their opportunities here to make some plays to try to quiet this crowd, but they weren't able to do it. If things keep going this way, this stadium is going to get even louder.
Up the middle, and he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. And he manages to get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
Second and 10.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down.
Four down. 45's the mic. They go.
Steps out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
Intercepted, and they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Gets to about the 27-yard line. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. They'll bring him down around the 43-yard line.
I like it. They're not afraid to try this defense over the middle. The quarterback saw man coverage and gave his receiver a chance to make a play. They picked up the first down. I wouldn't be surprised to see them come back to that play.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That'll make it second and four.
Thank you.
Just throws this one away. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He steps out around the 49-yard line.
Well, they didn't need much, so give it up to the defense for reading that one and making a sensational stop to keep them short for the first down.
And this is what power football is all about, folks.
3-9, go!
Gets it on the pitch. And he stops short of the first down. Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
Now they went with a toss play here, but no one on that defensive side of the ball was fooled. You got to give them credit for making a great play.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. And he
his tackle right around the 48-yard line.
The defense just met the blockers head-on and drove them back straight into the runner.
Second and 13. Ball on their own 48. Caught out in the open. Brought down at about the 43-yard line. He's taken down at the 32-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
First and 10. Ball on the 32. Slings it to his fullback.
Let's see if this coaching staff sticks with the short passing game, or if they decide to open it up a bit more.
From the 29-yard line, second down. He's tackled at the 26-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
Man, it's difficult to run on this defense when they put this kid up in the box.
Throw to the tight end. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal.
That was more than enough to pick up the first down. Next time, this defense will be playing on their heels.
First and goal from the one. Expect to see something straight up the middle. The PAT. So that's a 7-play, 48-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drop. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And they can forget about returning this one. Pittsburgh's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Fires out to his wideout. And they make the stop at the 45-yard line. First and 10. And he's got the freshman. That'll make it second and 4.
Hey, kill.
And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Tackle made at the 26.
Call it a gain of 13 yards. First down.
Caught, open field, knocked out of bounds, right around the 20.
Good for a gain of 6 yards.
Watch 14.
That'll make it second and 4.
Set a tone, fellas, let's set a tone. Hey, kill.
3-8. Broadway, taken down in the backfield.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That'll bring up 3-8.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Scrambling. The 10. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. Pittsburgh's lead is a touchdown. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Positive yardage.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and goal.
And down he goes at the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Vols. No need to pitch it as the quarterback's able to run it in.
I'll tell you what, when you're a quarterback and the goal line is right there, it's pretty hard to pitch the ball when you think you can get in. That's a smart decision to keep it for the score.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he adds the extra point. A 10-play, 77-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Slings it. He goes out of bounds at the 31-yard line. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
That's a great tackle at the 31.
No gain. That makes it fourth and four.
He's tackled at the 33-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From their own 33-yard line. Second down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's taken down
around the 32-yard line.
Push him out at the 43-yard line.
Getting the ball to your tight end and allowing him to make plays in the passing game can really open things up on the outside for your real speedsters.
Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. And the defensive end comes up with a big play.
Boy, he's quick as a cat, no question. He got tremendous penetration and was able to wrap him up for a loss there.
From their own 42-yard line, second down. Around the 44-yard line. And he hits. hits him hard at the 36-yard line. Fourth and long here after the sack. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Booming kick. He'll take it from the 18. He's taken down at the 25. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He fights forward to about the 26. From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
He's out of bounds at about the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That makes it fourth and eight.
Oh, excellent punt. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They'll bring him down around the 40-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. It out. The freshman makes the catch.
That's a gain of 38 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Watch the pass.
He scrambled. And they got him.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
So it'll be second and 14 after the setback.
Green eye, green!
Zips it to the tight end, and he's tackled around the 29-yard line.
Number 8 brings him down at the 29-yard line. That'll make it 39.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Tennessee is looking to go up by 3. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start, offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
Kick is up, it's got the distance, and it's good.
kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick pass. Brought down around the 37-yard line. Pittsburgh just took their first timeout. First and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Makes it out to about the 37-yard line. And he manages to get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. The Panthers are going to call their second timeout. Fires out to his receiver. He's at the 40, at the 30. And he's finally shoved out at the 18-yard line. First down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. He's got it out to his tight end. He's taken down at the 15-yard line. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. Only a few ticks left on the clock before halftime. I would expect he'll just squib kick this one. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. So we've played two quarters and a 10-10 tie in this game.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
We say it here all the time. It's not always about the X's and the O's. It can be about the Jimmys and the Joes. But I think Jimmy and Joe appear to be pretty evenly matched here. And this might not necessarily be about who has the better athlete, who has the more explosive player. This might come down to which guy maneuvering those X's and O's does so the most wisely.
Well, who's telling Jimmy and Joe where to line up? They got to know where they're supposed to go. So I think it is important. And the coaches, sometimes you got to break character. You know, sometimes you know you're a predominantly run team, and that's what you do, and you're going to line up and pound it. But sometimes you face a good defense that's playing really well, that they're not going to allow you to do that. And sometimes you got to get a little bit out of character. And I think which offense or which defense can take a few chances and get rewarded for those chances. Come up on the plus side of it. Create a big turnover. Set your offense up on the right side of it. How about you dial up one of those trick plays you got in your bag that you haven't used in a while that you think might could work and might could maybe bust open this game and give you a little bit of separation.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. 3-yard gain by the running back.
Second and seven.
from their own 28-yard line. It's second down. Gets out to about the 31.
Carries the ball. That's a gain of three on the play. That'll bring up third and four.
He has some room. He's at midfield. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 44. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Nice run, and he's brought down. From the 25-yard line, second down. The stop at the 23. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
Was able to stop him quickly. Good job by that senior safety.
From the 6-yard line, second down. Tackle made at the 5. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. And he's level at the 4. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Pittsburgh to kick. Excellent kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And down he goes to the 39-yard line. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's taken down at the 45.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
They come out in an empty backfield.
Hey, kill, kill, kill!
Slings it out there incomplete.
Was the intended receiver on the play.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Zips it to the back, and they got him for a loss.
Called a loss of 4 yards on the play.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Pittsburgh is up by 3. And he tackles him hard at the 17.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That brings up second and 13.
So that sack sets him back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. They'll drop him for a loss.
Number 4 was the intended receiver. That brings up third and 14.
What are you doing? They've got tight left, tight left. Four down, four down. Hey, check my 45, check my 45. Hot down, it's
he's going to go for the home run. In and out of his hands.
Number 14, the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and 14.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's at the 40. Makes it to the 37.
Gain of 14 on the way. That makes it first and 10.
Let's go.
And he is drilled at the 26.
Watch 14, watch 14.
With the 26-yard line. First down.
He heaves it to the end zone. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Tackle at the 15.
Makes the tackle. Call it a gain of 11 yards.
Watch 20, first steal down. That. Steal that. Steal that.
Here we go. Keep him deep.
Kill.
Gunner 3. 20.
Complete. He's got room. They'll bring him down at the 11.
I like that they're completing these underneath routes because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. And that's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
We're headed to the fourth quarter, and both of these defenses are still stealing the show. The Panthers with a 3-point lead. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Kicks up, and it is good. And with that field goal, we are all tied up.
Yeah, well, that was a clutch field goal without a doubt.
Tennessee ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. He's gobbled up in the backfield. It's second and 13. Ball on the 22-yard line.
Check Mike 45. Check
Mike 45.
225.
Got it and brought down immediately. He gets sacked on the play.
That makes it fourth and long.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. It's away and it's a booming punt. He's tackled at the 47-yard line. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. They'll make the sack. The pressure got to him that time.
Now they brought the heat here, and the linebacker was able to spring free for a big play.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
Dog four.
Green.
Hey, kill, kill, kill. Black connect.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's tackled at the 49-yard line.
Number 24 brings him down at the 49-yard line. Third down.
Kill it.
And he hits him hard at the 38.
Oh, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Just under three to go in regulation. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He takes it in at the 14. You look up at the clock, Herbie, and there's not a lot of time to make something happen here.
No, it's been ugly for both of these offenses. You got to think about maybe spreading out the defense, giving your quarterback a chance to either run or throw. Somebody's got to make a play here to determine the outcome of the game.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. He's immediately tackled. From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. And he's hit immediately. Fires quick, he catches another. One probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
From the 49-yard line, second down. He's under some heat, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That brings up third and 10.
For the sack, and he can't escape again.
It's tough to go down like that again, but an experienced quarterback like this knows how to come back from such adversity.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He really got a hold of that one.
If you don't rush things and avoid mistakes on offense, the worst thing that happens in this game is that you go into overtime.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. He's taken down at about the 19-yard line.
That's a gain of 17 on the play. First down.
Black five, black five. Green nine.
Check, check.
Dancer, dancer.
Now he's scrambling. He's out to the 30. There he goes. Slides down.
That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down.
Fires complete over the middle. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
Easy. Flare. Flare.
There's a strike complete. He's tackled at the 42.
Hey, kill, kill, kill. Back five. Back five.
That makes it first and 10.
Red pit.
He's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room.
Watch 14, watch 14.
Here we go.
Whiteout makes the first down catch.
Check, check. Dance, dance.
First down.
This one's going deep to the end zone. This one will fall incomplete.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Under a minute left. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Black five, black five. Green eight.
We're going to overtime. Well, we've had fun, folks, but we're not done yet because this game is heading to overtime. Back to the action here, and we get ready for overtime.
Three down, three down.
45's the mic. Left high. Three.
And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch.
Loss of 40 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
It's second down now, and 14 to go. Ball on the 29. That's a great tackle at the 34-yard line.
Loss of 5 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
Open receiver, no good.
You know, the quarterback's very fortunate that his wide receiver's getting up from that hit. That's a big hit by the defender. The quarterback should go up to his receiver and apologize for putting that ball in a position where he almost had his head taken off.
He launches one for the end zone. Almost intercepted. Low-scoring ball game, Kirk. You know, it only takes one big run, one big pass play, something like that, or maybe in the return game that could bust this thing wide open. From the 25-yard line, first down.
14, watch 14.
All day, just like that, just like that.
Yeah, motion, motion, motion. Motion, 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 motion. Three, three.
Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. And they push him out at the 14.
Tay, this guy is a pretty sure-handed weapon coming out of the backfield. And he showed some more good moves once he had the ball.
Heading for the corner.
knocked out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and goal. Here we go.
Check!
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. It's second and goal. Ball on the 3. And they make the stop
at about the 5-yard line.
Game in overtime. It's up, and he's got it.
What a fantastic ending. It's fitting that it came down to a single play. Both teams competed at a high level and laid it all out there.
Really great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. Tennessee 16, Pittsburgh 13. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nussler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.